Yesterday we were discussing 7th canto chapter 15 text 46. Till 46 we completed, today 47 after we are going to discuss. Okay, text 47. Pravattam cha nivrittam cha dvidham karma vairitam avartate pravrittena nirvrittena smrute amritam. Vajjuvat meaning, translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Sri Prabhupada Prabhupada Jai. Pravrittam, inclination for material enjoyment, cha and vrittam, cessation of material enjoyment, cha and vrittam, these two varieties, karma of activity, vaiditam, recommended in the Vedas. Avartate, one travels up and down through the cycle of samsara. By an inclination by the activity, but by ceasing such activity, Ashnute, one enjoys Amrita eternal life. Translation. According to the Vedas, there are two kinds of activities, Pravritti and Nivritti. Pravritti activity involves raising oneself from a lower to a higher condition of materialistic life. What is that? Pravritti. Whereas Nivritti means the cessation of material desire. Pravritti and Nivritti. Pravritti means going higher in material life, materialistic life. Nivritti means controlling, cessing the material desires. Okay. Through Pravritti activities, one suffers from material entanglement. But by Nivritti activities, one is purified and becomes fit to enjoy eternal blissful life. As confirmed in Bhagavad Gita 16.7, Pravritti cha Nivritti cha jana na vidur asuraha. The asuras, non-devotees, cannot distinguish between Pravritti and Nivritti. They cannot distinguish what is called Pravritti, what is called. Whatever they like, they do. Such persons think themselves independent of the strong material nature. Whatever they like, they do. Such persons think themselves independent of the strong material nature, and therefore they are irresponsible and do not care to act wisely. Many they just act like there is no supreme power. Nature has nothing to. They are the only controller because they are so rich, they are so powerful, whatever they want, they can go ahead and do it. That's what their idea. Many, many people. So, they are not at all caring for nature. They are not aware that nature is so powerful. Okay. Why? Because nature is not the energy of Krishna. Indeed, they do not distinguish between pious and impious activity. Bhakti, of course, does not depend on pious or impious activity. As stated in Srimad Bhagavatam 1.2.6, Savai Pumsam Paro Dharma Yato Bhaktir Adochade Ahituki Apratihata Vyatma Su Prasiddhati. The supreme occupation, dharma. Savai Pumsa Paro Dharma. Paro Dharma means the supreme dharma for all humanity. Savai Pumsa means for all humanity. What is that? Is that by which one man can attain to loving devotional service unto the transcendental Lord? Yato Bhaktir Adokshate Ahetuki Aprita. Such devotional service must be unmotivated. Ahetuki, there should not be any other motivation. Okay, only motivation is to please Krishna. Unmotivated, such devotional service must be unmotivated. Ahetuki Apratyata and uninterrupted in order to completely satisfy the self. So if our bhakti is unmotivated and uninterrupted, then we will become Yayatma Supersiddhati. We will be completely satisfied. Nonetheless, those who act wisely have a better chance to become devotees. Actually, bhakti is not depending upon the pious and impious activity, but if one does pious activity, there is better chance for him to become a devotee. It doesn't, bhakti does not depend on any kind of papa or punya, pious or impious. But still, if a person is pious person doing pious activity, he may become devotee easily. You can say it is like favorable. As Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita 7.16, Chaturvidha Vadanteva Jnana Sudhutna Arjuna, O Arjuna, four kinds of pious people render devotional service to me. Four type of people can become devotees. One who takes to devotional service even with some material motive is considered pious, and because he has come to Krishna, he will gradually come to the stage of bhakti. Okay. In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says actually that four type of people, Chaturvidha Vajante Maam Jana Sukirtino Arjuna, Artho Jigyasur Arthati Jnani Cha Vartarshala. Four type of people can easily become devotee, they will come to Krishna. Okay. So, Artho, Arthardi, Jnani, Jityasu. Means, Artho means the person who is distressed. And Arthardi means the desire of wealth, who want material profit, gain, money. Jnani, who knows things as they are. And Bhartarishabha, Jigyasu, the inquisitive. Okay. So these four type of people will come to Krishna. Okay. So, the distressed Artho, Gajendra, he was in so much problem and he had approached Krishna. Then Durva, desire of wealth, and inquisitive. So, this sages of Naimisaranya, Shaunakadi Rishi, they were inquisitive, they wanted to know, tell me about Krishna, so they approached Krishna. And Jnani, they are four Kumaras, Sanatan. These four Kumaras are Jnani, they know things as they are, so they approached Krishna. Okay, so that's what Krishna is saying in Bhagavad Gita. These people, the point is here, they are not going to Krishna for bhakti. But later on they turn into bhakta. This is the point here. Gajendra did not ask, give me pure devotion. Gajendra asked, I am in danger, please save me, my Krishna. Even he did not say name also. He just said, oh, you who are like this, who are like that. So Krishna thought, actually all the qualities are matching me, even though my name he is not saying, but let me go and help you. So he approached the Supreme Personality of Godhead when he was in distress to get relief, and later on he became devotee. Durva, he wanted material gain, so he approached Krishna. Later on, he also, those material desires actually get purified. The point is here, even somebody goes to Krishna for some material desire as a pious activity or something like that, those things will get purified by the power of bhakti. Okay, so Durva went for material gain, kingdom and all. Later on he became pure devotee. He said, I don't want it, I want bhakti. Okay, same way, Kanakadi Rishi, they were having inquisitiveness. Right? And four Kumaras, they were Jnanis. Okay, so one who takes to devotional service, even with some material motive, is considered pious, and because he has come to Krishna, he will gradually come to the stage of bhakti. The point is, because he has considered this thing, what he considered? He considered that Krishna can fulfill my desire. Krishna is so powerful. Krishna can make me wealthy. Krishna can make me distress-free. Krishna can answer my questions. So these people are considered pious because they are approaching Krishna. No problem, even though they are approaching because of material desire, material motive, it's okay, but still they are approaching Krishna. Na? So they are pious, and because they came to Krishna, they will gradually become devotee. They will come to this with bhakti. Then, like Dhruva Maharaj, he will refuse to accept any bhakti. So when they come to the stage of pure bhakti, so Prabhupada is saying, like Dhruva Maharaj, he will refuse to accept any material benediction from the Lord. Swami Kirtato Asni Varam Nayach. I don't want anything else. Therefore, whenever one is materially inclined, one can take Buddha's shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna and Balram or Gaur Nitai. So that he will be very soon be purified of all material desires. Shipram Bhavati Dharmatma. Shashwat Shanti Nigachi. Very quickly he will become devotee if he takes shelter of Krishna. Okay. Then, as soon as one is freed from inclination toward pious and impious activities, he becomes a perfect candidate for returning home back to God. Okay. Very important purports are here, so try to focus on the line by line. Okay. So you can open in your portal or book or website wherever, or when you are home. Okay. 7th canto, 15th chapter, 48 shloka, 48-49. Okay. 47 just now. Hinsram Dravamayam Kamyam Agni Hotra. शांतिदं दर्शस्य पूर्णमासस्य चातुर्मास्यं पशुसुतः एतदिष्टं प्रवर्ताख्यं कृतं प्रभुतं एव च पूर्तं सुरालया रामकूप आजीव्यादिलक्षणम् हिंस्रम ए सिस्टम ऑफ किलिंग एंड सैक्रिफाइसिंग एनिमल्स द्रव्यमयम् रिक्वायरिंग मच कैलोरीया काम्यम् full of unlimited material desires, Agni Hotra Adi ritualistic ceremonies such as the Agnihotra, Ashantidam causing anxiety, Darsha ritualistic ceremony, and Purnamasa, the Purnamasa ritualistic ceremony, also Chaturmasa of the Purnamasa, the Pashu, the Pashu Yagya, Sutara, Soma Yagya, Eta, the form of the system, the world, the Akyam, the one and material attachment. Vaishwa Deva Anitani Supreme Personality of Godhead Prahutam is a ceremony called Baliharan Eva Itcha also Purtam for the benefit of the public. Sura Alaya constructing temples for demigods, Arama resting houses, gardens, Kupa digging wells, Ajiv Adi. Ajivya Adi activities like distributing food and water lashans. Okay. Translation. The ritualistic ceremonies and sacrifices known as Agnihotra Yagya, Darsha Yagya, Purnamasa Yagya, Chaturmasa Yagya, Pashu Yagya, Soma Yagya, and Somyagya are all symptomized by the killing of animals and the burning of many valuables, especially food grains, all for the fulfillment of material desires and the creation of anxiety. Performing, because these yagyas they used to do only for some material benefit. They want some sun, they want some kingdom. So there is a okay, do yagya. And you will get it. Okay. So they should do for that. So performing such sacrifices, worshipping Vasudeva, and performing the ceremony of Baliharan, which all supposedly constitute the goal of life, as well as constructing temples for demigods, building resting houses and gardens, digging wells for the distribution of water, establishing booths for the distribution of food, and performing activities for public welfare. These are all symptomized by attachment to material desires. Okay, maximum time people do this for material desires, like setting the distributing food any kind of public welfare, building resting houses, dharamshala, earlier they should make, and gardens, and make digging the wells or arranging water facilities. All these things people do only for some material benefit. Okay. Dravya suksham vipakasya umo ratir pakshaya ainam dakshinam tumam darsakoshadi virudha annam reta iti kshema spitrayanam punarbhava aikaika ishenam purvam utva puveh jayate. Dravya suksham vipaka, the paraphernalia offered as oblation, the fires, food grains, which could be cha and dhuma, turned to smoke, or the demigod in charge of smoke, Ratri, the demigod in charge of night, apakshya in the dark wood made of moon, ayanam, the demigod in charge of the passing of the sun, dakshinam in the southern zone, soma, the moon, darsha, returning positive plant life on the surface of the earth, viruda, vegetation in general, the birth of fermentation. Annam putre deta asimen iti, in this way chama isha, O King Yudhishthira, Lord of the Earth, pitri jnanam dravya putri birth from the father sin puna bhava again and eka eka shena parapetra anupurvam sakshati, according to the gradation dhutva tekva dhutva again tekva kya in this way jayate vani. My dear King Yudhishthira, when oblations of ghee food grains like barley and sesame are offered in sacrifice, they turn into celestial stone. Now you have learned to, and now you understand what's the process. So when oblations of ghee, okay, generally this question may be there in mind, how it works, there is the process now. Okay, how the thing is working. Narad Maharshi is telling to Yudhishthira Maharaj that when, my dear King Yudhishthira, when oblations of ghee and food grains like barley and sesame are offered in sacrifice in Yajna Devakutna, they turn into celestial smoke, that is smoke, celestial smoke, which carries one to successively higher planetary systems like the kingdoms of Uma, Ratri, Krishna Paksha, Dakshinam, and ultimately the moon. They can go to these higher planets. Then, however, the performers of sacrifice descend. Okay, anyway, he did this thing and he reached to the higher planet system, but still, what will happen? He will descend again to earth to become. So, he will come down, maybe become some residents of moon or some. Any higher planet like Swarga, heaven, or any heavenly planet. But he will come back. And what he will become? House, creepers, vegetables, and food grains. Who? The same person who did yajna, he will become again those food grains and all that. These are eaten by, then what will happen? These are, very nice question. Can you just text me here? Here? Okay. Where I am speaking, that chat if you do it. I'm not getting informed. Anyway, I'll come to your point. So, these are, they came down and then they become these all herbs and all. Then these are eaten by different living entities. What? These vegetables and grains. These are eaten by people, living entities. And then they turn into semen, which is injected into female bodies. Okay. Thus one takes birth again and again. How this process happened? Now interesting. He did yajna, he went to higher planet system, he came down in the form of rain. And he became the food grains and all vegetables and all, then some animal ate. Animal also can eat, human also can eat. It depends. So that he will eat and then it will become into semen and then it will be transferred into, injected into female body. And this way one will take birth again. This is the same. This is explained in Bhagavad Gita 9:21. Tetam bhuktva swarga lokam vishalam chine punye martya lokam vishanti evam trai dharmam anuprapanna gata gatam kama kama lapte. When those who follow the pravritti marga have enjoyed heavenly sense pleasure. Because many people in India think, I want to go heaven. That's why all this heaven thought should be finished. Because after going to heaven also, one has to come back. Okay. So, when these people who follow the pravritti marga have enjoyed heavenly sense pleasure, they return to this mortal planet again. Thus, through the Vedic principle, they achieve only flickering happiness. Following the pravritti marga, the living entity who desires to be promoted to the higher planetary system performs sacrifices regularly, and how he goes up and comes down again is described here in Srimad Bhagavatam as well as in Bhagavad Gita. It is said, Traigunya Vishya Veda, yesterday also the stroke came. The Vedas deal mainly with the three modes of material nature. The Vedas, especially three Vedas, namely Sama, Yajur and Rig Veda, vividly describe this process of ascending to the higher planet and returning. But Krishna advises Arjuna, Traigunya Vishya Veda means Traigunya Arjuna. One has to transcend these three modes of material nature and then one will be released from the cycle of birth and death. Otherwise, although one may be promoted to a higher planetary system such as Chaturruga, one must again come down. Chine punye martilokam vishanti. After one's enjoyment due to pious activity, whatever prepaid is like prepaid. You have recharged, you went to Swarga or Chandraloka or whatever heavenly planet, and you are enjoying there, and this recharge battery is coming down, 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 down. And when it's finished, you also down. Okay. So, after one's enjoyment due to pious activities is finished, one must return to this planet in rainfall. And first, so you will come in the rainfall. Barish ke saath girenga aaram se. And then what will happen? He will take birth. First, he will take birth as a plant or creeper. Na? Windy banke paida hoega phir. Or creeper. Hai na? Wo aise rehta na? Loki ka bail. Wo aise sab. Creeper or plant. And which is eaten by various animals. Phir ek bakri aake kha legi. Bakra. Which is eaten by various animals, including human beings, you know, they will make sabji, including human, and turn to semen. This semen is injected into the female body, and thus the living entity takes birth. Happy birthday. Okay, those who return to earth in this way take birth, especially in higher families like those of Brahmins. Okay, whoever comes from upper higher planet, they generally, they may take birth as Brahmins, in the family of Brahmins. It may be remarked in this connection that even the modern so-called scientists who are going to the moon are not able to stay there, but are returning to their laboratories. They cannot stay. Therefore, whether one goes to the moon by modern mechanical arrangements or by performing pious activities, one must return to earth. That is clearly stated in this verse and explained in Bhagavad Gita. This is very clearly, Prabhupada is making everything very clear, very easy to understand. Even if one goes to the higher planetary system, Jnanti Dev Vrta Devan, one's place there is not secure. One cannot live there eternally. One has to come back. That's the point. Why we are trying to do temporary settlement. Even after going to heaven, you have to come back. What about going to London and New York and Sydney? Everyone people are trying to go there, and there people are trying to go moon, and moon people are trying to go heaven. Why everyone has to come back? What is the point in trying for temporary things? Try for eternal, which is Vaikuntha and Goloka. Go there, live there. Yedgatvana nivartante. Tad dhamparamam. Krishna said very clearly, if you come to my place, you are not going to go back. Simple. Okay. So, wherever one goes, if one, even if one goes to the hybrid system, one's place there is not secure, one must return to Martyaloka, means this earthly planet. Abrahma Bhuvanan Loka Punar Avartino Arjuna. Somebody asked this question. Okay. Aside from Abrahma Bhuvanan Loka Punar Avartino Arjuna, aside from the moon, even if one goes to Brahma Loka, one must return. Okay. यम प्राप्त न निवर्तन्ते तत् धाम परमं मम. ये बात, if one goes back home, back to God, he need not return to this material world. Okay. What was the question? Can you post me WhatsApp? Even in my laptop, I have not got it. Post, I can read fully what was the question. Otherwise, I'll move to the next question. Are you sending question? Acha, Indra, Brahma comes back as well after their post. Yeah, they can come. They may come, they may not come. It depends. And it's not like for everyone. The after go, like Indra is doing a service. Okay. Okay, so this Indra is a post. So the person who is sitting on the post of Indra or Brahma, they are doing their service to Krishna. Okay, so if they do their service perfectly, they'll go back home to God from there only. You know? But if they don't do it properly, they'll come back. Some other person may become Indra, and then person who was Indra, he will become some other person. So that story is there. Once Indra came down because of his mistake and he became animal, he became even pig, hog. So that incident happened, he became hog. Okay. And even if once this thing happened, so Nahush Maharaj was made king, Indra. So Maharaja Nahush became Indra. And he did a mistake. And he also came down and he became lizard. Yeah. Okay. So rules of nature is same for everyone. I don't know why I'm not getting your questions in my laptop. It's all coming in the phone. Now I cannot read it so far. Ah, now it is. So it's not like everyone, I mean, this is a process. Some may become creeper, vegetable like that. People who went to the heavenly planet, they may come like that. This is the process explained. The general process. Some may become liberated from there only. Some may even get higher planet, like some may be in the fourth stage. He may even go higher after doing something great there. It's like that. But the point here is not like exactly finding out who went where. The point here is that anyone goes anywhere in this material world, they have to come back to Martyaloka one day. Okay, that's the point here. Okay, so today is such a thing. So we are discussing till 10 o'clock. Okay. So you can rejoin please. Okay, so the point is that in this material world, we should not try to find a place, secure place, because nothing is secure, nothing is eternal. That's the point here. Now, who went where, and that's not very, those details are not very important, like whether everyone will come or not. Now, some may come Arthalo, some may even go to even higher, and then they come. So it depends person to person. Okay, is it clear? 52. Shall I go to 52? Still you have to. Okay, thank you. But your question is quite logical and very good. And Brahma also same thing. Generally, Brahma is so highly elevated personality is made Brahma. So he will go back to Krishna, generally. Yeah, if Indra is good, then he can go back to Krishna. Yes, he can go. Anybody, they do good service. So that's the process. There is a direct process going directly to Goloka. But there is a gradual process also. Because some people may have, desire, I don't want to check any other option. Like, you know, you went to a shopping mall and you love the some particular brand, you know, like some for like jeans you went and you want to purchase it, so you know like Levi's is the best, I like that only, so you directly go to Levi's shop, that's it, that's so you will get a recognition. But somebody may think, let me try, you know, so you will go to Peter England, you will go to Benetton, you will go here, all those brand you will check. And he knows anyway I have to purchase from Levi's. But I will just see what's happening in other shops also. So he will go and he will not purchase anywhere. He will just see, okay. And he will come back to Levi's and purchase. But in the third case, a person may go and check in other shops and may get illusioned there or allured there. And he may purchase there only. Anyway, it's okay. So he may get entangled there. So some people go directly to Goloka, some may have this idea, okay, anyway, what is the harm in becoming Indra and enjoying some time in heaven and then trying to go to Goloka, let me go. So some people will go to some moon or Vidyadhara Loka, Maharloka, Janaloka, Tapaloka, Sataloka, heavenly, all these things they may go. So gradually, step by step, they may upgrade themselves, then they may, from there, Brahmaloka, they will go. Goloka or back. Many chances, the residents of Brahmaloka, there are chances that all will go. Many maximum will go to back in tower. They will get liberated. But sometimes they may come back also. It's not like, the point is that the position is not eternal. You cannot say that everybody will come down. Or you cannot say that everybody will go. It depends. But the point is that the position is not eternal. It's temporary. Okay, even for Brahma. Okay, so one may be Brahma is the owner of this universe. Even if Brahma is Brahma, that's not that is also not an eternal position. It's also a temporary position. Okay, makes sense. So this thing is the third point is that in case one is trying to go in a gradual way, step by step, all the planet you want to enjoy and then go. In between, you may forget his goal that he want to go to Goloka and he will be trapped and then you may become some animal. Now Smaras are such a nice person. That's what they made him Indra. Some useless fellow they will not make Indra. Okay. They are making somebody Indra. That he should be a very qualified person. Now Smaras was the one. And they found that he's the best person to be Indra. Responsible person. He can take this responsible position. So they made after going there. Mistake happened. Down. You know, so be careful. Today I am chanting 16 rounds, 24 rounds, 100 rounds. Very nice. I am reading every day. Wonderful. If a mistake happens, we go down. So be careful. So nobody should have that pride that I am such a great devotee, I am such a powerful, I am very boss of everyone. Okay. Any mistake, any offense, down. Okay, so be careful. Are, what is this? We are having so many questions. Okay, how about Sadashiva? Sadashiva is in already in the Adhyatmik Jagat. The position is in Adhyatmik Jagat. Sadashiva only. Okay, from Sankarshan comes Sadashiva. So he is eternal person. Sadashiva don't have death. It's a good question actually, many people don't know. So Brahma has death, but Sadashiv don't have death. Okay. Rudra also will be over. When the universe So Sadashiva expansion is Rudra, which is in material world. So material world is over, Rudra also will go and merge Sadashiva like that. But Sadashiva is eternal, eternal person. Okay. And when material world, this actually Kailash is like Sadashiva, half is Sadashiva, half is Shambhu. So Sadashiva plays, this Kailash is eternal, nothing is going to happen. Sadashiva don't have death. Shambhu may or may not, I don't know about Shambhu, I have to check exactly. That much detail, I have seen, I have read that, but I am not able to take a peek or no, about Shambhu. Okay, what will exactly happen to Shambhu? Very nice, you are going in very detail. That's good. Actually, it's very interesting. Okay, anybody want to learn exactly in all detail what how this creation happened, distribution happened? There is a specific seminar about it. Let me know if you want. I can refer. Okay. Shall we go to text 52? Okay. निषेकादिशं शानान्तै संस्कारै संस्कृतो द्विजः इन्द्रियेषु क्रियाय ज्ञान ज्ञानदीपेषु ध्रुवति. ओके, इफ इट इज डिस्कनेक्टेड यू कैन रीजॉइन टुडे टिल 10 o'clock वी हैव अ सेशन. ओके, सो what about Brahma and Shiva? Just now we explained Prabhuji whole about Brahma and Shiva. Everything I explained, nah? And I explained what will happen to Brahma. Brahma can go, and if not done properly, Satyatani can come down. Same about Rudra and Sadashiva, I told. Right? I just explained it. Okay. Nishekadi, the beginning of life, the purificatory process of Garbhadhan, performed when the father begets it. So now remember, okay, in between question and answer, you forget what was happening. So he went up and came down in the rain, became creeper and was eaten by some animal or human being and became semen and then and injected in the female body and then took birth. Okay, this is the thing happened. Okay. Nishikadi, the beginning of life, that's when you the process of Garbhadhan, performed when the father begets a child by discharging the womb of the mother. Samshan Antai. And at death, when the body is put into crematorium and burned to ashes, samskarai, by such people, it causes samskrita, purified dija, it like from Brahman, indriyeshu, into the senses, kriya, yagyan, activities and sacrifices which elevate one to a higher life system, jnana deepeshu, by enlightenment in real knowledge, juvati offers. Translation, a twice born Brahmana. Okay, we are reading translation of 7.15.52. A twice born Brahmana, Dvija, gains his life by the grace of his parents through the process of purification known as Garbhadhan. Okay, Dvija gains his life by the grace of his parents in the process of Garbhadhan, purificatory process. There are also other processes of purification. So first is Garbhadhan. Sanskar means the process of purification. So first process is Garbhadhan. Second, and then there are other processes also. Until the end of life, when the funeral ceremony, Antyeshti Kriya is performed. So that is the Antim Sanskar. The last rite or last purificatory process is Antyeshti Kriya. And that is why, because it is last